hadith. Let me read you the hadith. Did you not ask? Did you not ask me for the hadith?
Was it in the camera or outside?
Why off camera?
No, I'll tell you why.
Because yeah, no, hold on. Why off camera?
Let him answer.
Let him answer.
Ask me a question. Yeah. Because off camera you're like a kitten. You don't speak like that.
Kitten! I'm not like a kitten.
Yes.
Do you start? Okay, I'm like a kitten. I'm here now, like a kitten. Do you want the hadith? Do you want the hadith?
I know the hadith.
You don't want the hadith,
okay.
Because all your little puppies, they have no clue.
You're about to run away, innit?
Yeah, of course he's running.
We can't handle the truth.
He's not a pagan. He's a Christian pagan.
Okay. Right, look at these Muslims. Wow. Oh boy, the wrong brothers.
Babies in the Bible.
About Muhammad.
They're killing babies in the Bible.
Babies alive. Yeah, yeah. No, yeah, sorry. About
Muhammad.
About the Bible.
About the Bible.
About the Bible. About the Bible. This man who run from Christian Prince, run from DCCI, run from me, run from everybody
for Christian
in this park.
He ran for foolishness. He walk away for foolishness.
Can't handle the truth.
If you don't shout, I'll speak to you.
Stay and debate me.
If you don't shout, I'll speak to you.
Stay and debate me. And I want a moderator.
If you speak like human, I'll speak to you.
I want a moderator.
Get a moderator. As long as you don't shout.
I
will speak to you on a condition don't shout. Would you do that?
He can't, he's on roids.
So will you interrupt me?
No, I will try my best to not interrupt.
I'll try my best. So there you go. We might fall top.
Yeah, no.
There you go.
Hey.
Okay, fair enough. So now, can we choose a topic?
Okay.
Because I've got my topic.
The one that's upon.
Let me choose my topic. My topic is steroids.
He cannot just skip it and skip
talking. Yeah, true. But here is your question. If you agree,
oh, why did you ask him then?
Bro, he doesn't.
Why did you ask him?
The topic we've been debating all day is jihad. You've been running away from it all day. But do you agree with that topic? Let's close out that topic with a moderator. You said you won't interrupt me, I don't interrupt you.
I asked you clearly.
Is that agreed?
I said the topic you want to support.
See, he wants to change the topic.
My topic is jihad.
Because that's what we've been debating all day. You're running to the oneness of God because that's your safe zone.
No, get away.
Because you know that we won't infiltrate Islam.
It's your danger zone.
Oneness of God. Oneness of God. Talk about the real issues. Talk about Jesus and Muhammad.
I tell you the oneness of God. Why? Because if we establish the true God, then whatever comes after you have to accept it. Because if you accept this true God, we have to accept everything from him.
Yes.
Earlier on, when I asked you about killing children, you said because from God, you have to accept it. So you don't have a problem with Islam because he says fighting or something. You have a problem with Islam because you believe it's not from God. That's the main point. So let us see.
My topic is jihad.
Oneness of God, you accept that.
Let's toss a coin. Ah, you see now, he doesn't even want to go fair.
No,
don't even want to go fair, bro. No, because now all day.
We were still on this.
Okay, fair enough. Then we have to decide a way, brother. Because all day we've been discussing jihad.
What topic?
Simple.
What topic? About violence in the Bible.
Right, now, okay. One topic. Right. Now, you're saying you want to pick a topic and I pick a
yes.
topic.
So first fight right. topic, then a topic.
That means I get a freebie. I pick.
Just get on with it, man. No, no,
just go. I pick. No, because I was going easy on you. Now I want to discuss Muhammad being bewitched. That's what I want to discuss. I want to discuss Muhammad being bewitched. What's your topic?
My topic is the Bible. Violence in the Bible.
So how are we going to do this, Chumpy? Question for question?
No, you have to speak about the first topic for like 10 minutes, maybe 10 minutes. Then we move on about
that. Are you going to run, Chumpy?
I'm not.
If you run, seriously. When we finish.
Kane, behave like an adult. Adult, behave like an adult.
Have you got Adbol?
No, you're serious, man.
You're serious.
Anyway, have
when
you
we
seen?
Finish your topic.
Yes. Then we move on to your topic. Yeah.
We're going to move on to your topic.
Yeah, but remember,
if you shout, you walk away.
If you start shouting, as I mentioned,
right. Remember, you said you may interrupt me, I may interrupt you.
No, listen, brothers. As everyone knows, you can go to my channel. Every Sunday I have a class at 7:30. Okay? So now we are 6:30. Okay? So 10 minutes, okay? Then I have to walk. Okay? And walking away.
Who's gonna time this?
Yeah, someone time this.
No. I want a bystander.
Anyone, last time I like Christian silence. Christian silence. Oh, let me talk about the one that's of God anyway. No, about the violence. It's my one.
I don't mind which topic we start with, as long as you don't run when you finish
violence.
Your topic.
No,
wait, 10 minutes.
So what's the topic? You want to start with yours?
Is the Bible from God concerning the violence?
Let's start.
Okay, now we're going to have a conversation for 10 minutes. Now, we as a human being, God gave us natural creation and a sound reason. You don't have to be Muslim to possess that, okay? You don't have to be Muslim to know you see someone stepping on a baby's head, it is wrong, okay? Except if it's unintentionally, everyone knows unintentionally, okay? Now, if you read the Bible, that's supposed to be from God in Samuel 1:15. Clearly, explicitly says, go kill the babies and infants. Why? Not because those babies are going to grow up as an evil man. Therefore, based upon God's foreknowledge, he's going to punish them. Okay? No. Because something happened 400 years ago. It's like you telling to the Jewish people, go kill the babies and the children of the Germans. Because Hitler did something to your forefathers. Everyone says, no, hold a minute. Their forefathers have not refused it. So in the Bible says, go kill the babies, donkeys, children, infants, both stop them alive. Okay? So anyone with a sound reason will say, hold a minute. Why? Is it because natural disaster? It's understandable. Is it because they're gonna grow up as evil people? That's understandable. Based upon God's foreknowledge and justice. No, because something happened 500 years ago that have nothing to do with it, God said do it. Violence, clearly, okay? That is not justified, okay? I've already explained about if they say, you know what, because those children, they're gonna grow up as evil. No, the Bible gives the context. Now watch this. In the Bible, if your wife saves you from a fight, just cut off her hand.
Jumping all over the place.
No, that's violence. That's violence. That's violence. Violence. Yes, thank you. It's violence. So now, wait.
So it's violence.
Yeah, it's violence.
Don't interfere.
I'm talking about the Bible violence. Okay? Now,
I'm talking about violence.
That's the topic. Violence in the Bible. That's the topic. Okay, my point here. Is it okay to slaughter a baby's alive because of a sin that happened 400 years ago?
Right. Here's my answer. Muslims, open your ears. Now, if you hear the truth, don't just shut your heart up because you're Muslim. I want you to hear the truth. Right. Now, I want you to imagine a group of people that were against the children of Israel. These are God's chosen people. God's chosen people who were 400 years in subjugation in Israel. They had now been set free and were traveling through the wilderness on their way to Canaan. The Amalekites, right, who you're speaking of, were not enemies of God. God did not have a problem with them. Anyone can go to the Bible and check this. God had a problem with the Canaanites. The Canaanites were Amorites who were worshipping a god called Molech, who was putting their babies and burning them alive. God had a problem with burning them alive. He was now sending the Israelites to go and slaughter the same tribe who were burning babies alive. The Amalekites, who he's speaking of, started to attack the Israelites on their journey to Canaan. They attacked them from behind. Remember, there's millions of Israelites. They'd attack Israelites, sometimes the front wouldn't even know what was going on. And God held his patience. The Amalekites even teamed up with the Midianites and they attacked Israel. So now God said, slaughter them. Slaughter them all. Because now you're messing with my chosen people and you're going to get it. This is the judgment of God. This is what happened. So okay. Now, hold on. Now, I just want to round it off. Now, I want you to understand this, people. When God makes a judgment, it is true. I want you to think about the people that were slaughtered. The men. They were the propagators, the leaders. They were slaughtered. Why? Because if they're left alive, they will come back and seek revenge. Hold on. The young boys, they were slaughtered. They were slaughtered. If they were left alive, they would grow to come back and seek revenge. Now, the babies. The babies who this man is speaking of and who Shamsi is speaking of. Think about what happened to the babies. According to the Bible, babies are innocent. Hold on, listen. The babies are innocent. If the babies are innocent, where do they go? They go to heaven.
Show me the Bible says go to
hell. Right? If they are innocent, they do not go to hell, they go to heaven, according to the Bible. Now, you have to think. So when God killed these babies, he not only stopped them growing up and perpetuating the ugly culture of burning babies, but he saved their souls.
Okay, now,
and now they're eternally living with God in heaven.
No problem.
He gave them salvation.
That's a pure lie. Right? Read the Bible. Watch. Let me read the Bible. He's doing takia. Watch this.
No, watch.
Watch this. Now go attack the Amalekites and totally destroy all that belongs to them. Do not spare them. Put them to death. Men, women, children, infants, cattle, innocent people. You slaughtered them alive. How you slaughtered someone innocent? Watch this.
You don't agree with me.
It's my time. I'm the one the Lord sent to anoint your king over his people, Israel. So listen now to the message from the Lord. This is what the Lord Almighty says. I will punish Amalekite for what they did to Israel. Samuel and Saul came 400 years after the event. That was not the same time. This guy is lying. So it's my time. So now God said,
so
according to him, the Jews in the Israelites, because he believed they are chosen ones, they should go kill the Germans. Let me finish.
You made it up.
The Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says the reason you go kill them because they did something to Israel or to Israel. This clearly in the Bible, in Samuel 15, go kill their babies. Brothers, would you kill someone innocent?
No.
Okay, this guy, that's why a Christian, you cannot debate with them.
Now it's my time.
Now it's my time, because we still talk about the violence in the Bible. And it's my time, it's my topic. Now says go slaughter them. Do not spare them. Hold a minute, what about donkeys? The donkeys did something to Israel? Donkeys, maybe his forefather did something. So the donkeys
kill the black dog.
The donkeys,
what do they do?
Go off topic. It's his sign of weakness. You cannot deal with me. So the donkeys, why they getting killed? Maybe the donkey's great-grandfather did something to Israel as well. Skin donkeys, man. So my point here, clearly, he has no point to stand on. Now listen, my point here. No, it's my time, it's my topic. So I ask, and you question, you ask. So now, look, it's my time, yeah, it's my time. So you ask your question. Now, my question clearly, is it okay? Yes or no? Now you're going to justify it, of course, going to say from God. If you're going to say it's from God, then we Muslims, anything you're going to answer me, I'm going to say from God. So why is it okay for you to do everything because God said it, and it's not okay for us because God said it? Why your God has to be better than my God? If this is the case, we should debate in which one is the true God. That's which makes sense. So my point here clearly, simple question, is it okay to slaughter a baby's life and to burn your daughter alive? Yes or no?
Right, now, I've already answered the question. I said it's a judgment. I've already said and given reasons why God judged.
No, is it okay? Yes
why
or no?
God I said yes.
Yes, okay.
And I've given reasons. Hold on a minute. You said I was lying. Hold on. I'm going to prove I wasn't lying. Right? I'm going to go to Numbers 14:45. Right? And this is talking about the Amalekites who were attacking Israel. They were attacking Israel. They attacked Israel again while they were still in the desert. And in Judges 3:13, they joined with the Moabites in attacking Israel in Judges 6:3. They invade Israel whenever the